Okay, so now that we know what is a lambda expression and what is a functional interface, let me show you in this lesson why functional programming is so important with an example. Okay, so let's jump on to the IntelliJ code editor and see some live coding. Okay, so now I am in the IntelliJ code editor. What I'll do is I'll just create a new example. Let's call it 02 and let me, get rid of everything from here. And what is the problem statement here? The problem statement is very interesting. Let's assume that, your manager just walks up to you and asks you to, write a code that print the employees whose salary is less than a salary limit. Okay, so this is the requirement that we'll be working on, right? So we have to, print all the employees whose salary is less than the salary limit. Now you might have realized, oh, this is a very simple problem to code, and you straight away just start coding, right? So let's do that. Okay, so let me create a method, right? Let's call it private static void. Let's call it print employees, okay? Please print employees. And what you would want to do here is maybe say list of employee list, and obviously we want to give a salary limit, so we can say salary limit. Okay, right, so what we're going to do in this method is we're going to print out the employees whose salary is less than the salary limit. Okay, so for that what I'll do is I'll just loop through all the employee list. So employee list is just a simple for loop, and what we'll do is here we'll say if e dot get salary, employee dot get salary is, let's say, greater than salary limit less than 0, and then we'll just do println employee, okay. So what we're doing here is we're just looping through the employee list and we're just printing the employees whose salary is less than the salary limit. This is absolutely fine, there's no problem with this. What we'll do here is, of course, we will just, here what we need to do is we'll say list of employee, and let's just fetch all the employees from our employee data, okay? And then let's do print employees. Let's pass the employees here. And along with the employees, what we need to do is a salary limit. So I'll say new big decimal. Let's say this is the limit, okay? So now if I just try to run this program, you can see it has actually printed all the salaries, which are less than this salary limit, which is good, right? But the thing is, in software, nothing is constant, right? So what happens is the next day your manager walks up to you and says, okay, Saz, you have to write another, program. And this time you have to print the employees which are, greater than the salary limit. I need to find who is getting the maximum salaries, right? And then, okay, so you say, okay, that is interesting. That is quite easy for me to do. What you will do is you'll say print employees. So you'll just, let's say, copy paste this code, okay? And write another code. And here, what you'll do is you'll do print employees less than, let's call it that. And let's say this is greater than, right? And here you'll just change it. And obviously we'll just refactor this. So we'll say print and let's call another one. And let's call this as greater than, okay? So it didn't take much time to actually write this code, right? So what I'll also do to make it clear which is greater than and less than is, I'll just let's call it as, you know, less than, and the next one greater than. Okay, I have a list which is printing the less than and a greater than. So let me just execute this now. Okay, so here I have less than, you know, five people are less than that, and there are around, you know, six people who are earning more than that salary limit, and which is good. But if you just see this program, these two methods exactly look the same except this line, right? Now what this is telling us that is that if we could have, you know, just passed in this piece of code, then we could have actually reused the entire function instead of writing this new method again, right? And that's exactly what functional programming is all about, right? That we should be able to pass in some function as a parameter which can be used inside another, you know, method or function, right? So let's see how we can improve this code. Okay, so what I'll do is I'll create a, you know, basically let's create an interface. Okay, and let's call it as employee filter. Okay, and in this employee filter, this is just an interface, so we'll just have a single abstract method. Okay, so that's it, right? So we just have a single abstract method inside the interface, so that qualifies for a functional interface, right? So as per the definition of functional interface, a functional interface is an interface that has only one abstract method in it. Okay, right? And so if it is a functional interface, we can very well annotate with functional interface. And this annotation does not make it a functional interface. Even without this annotation, it is actually a functional interface, right? Right. So this is a functional interface, right? Now, how do we use it, right? So what we can now do is I'll just copy paste this method again. And this time I'm writing a very generic method. I'll just rename it to, let's say, print employees. And instead of giving the, you know, salary limit here, what I'll supply here is actually the employee filter. So I'll say employee filter filter. Okay, now this filter is something that I want to pass in here, and then call the filter dot test method, and let's say employee. Okay, so if it just passes that test, and then, you know, it just prints employee, right? Now what I've done here is I have just created a filter, and I don't know what that filter is because I have not implemented that filter, but I'm just passing that, you know, as a parameter. And so this piece of code is now present inside this method, but the implementation is still not there actually, right? We have never implemented it. Now, so how do I implement this? So this is a functional interface now. So which means I can actually create a Lambda expression for this. Okay, so let me show you how that can be done now. So how that can be done is in the print employees, and I can pass in employees. And now here is where I define this filter. How do I define this filter? Defining this filter is very easy. All I have to do is I have to provide an implementation for this method. This method, it just takes an employee object and returns a Boolean. Okay, so what I have to do here is it just takes an employee object, and we have get salary dot compared to, you know, and then we have to just give the salary limit, which is nothing but new dot big decimal, let's say. Greater than zero, right? What I've done here is I'm just printing the salaries which are greater than zero. Same thing I can do now here for the less than as well. Okay, and I'll just comment out the previous code. So now if I just try to print this, what happens? If I just try to run this, it still runs, right? And we have, sorry, I've just, this should be less than, right? And if I just run the code now, and we have here the, you know, less than and the greater than, still works fine. But if you just pay close attention to it, we have just not duplicated the code. So we have a single method that is handling, you know, both the use cases, print employees whose salary is less than the, you know, salary limit, and print employees whose salary is greater than the salary limit. Why? Because we are actually implementing the functional interface in the runtime. The advantage of functional programming is that we have avoided code duplication in our, you know, code, and we have actually written a single method that handles both these use cases. So I hope I have motivated you enough to, you know, explain why this functional programming is so important in Java and why you should actually learn functional programming. And it just opens the door for many possibilities in Java now. Okay, so in the next lesson, we'll just deep dive and also look at the Lambda expression syntax. What are the different syntax possible in Lambda expression? Thanks for watching and see you in the next video.